Left Ventricle Cardiopulmonary Interactions by Dr. Lara Shekerdemian.
So if we move on now to the ventilation in the left heart, I think the key here, and it's something that a lot of people have struggled with getting their heads around, but I try and keep it simple, is to understand the impact of transmural pressure, the concept of transmural pressures, and then their impact on the heart. So simply put, a transmural pressure is the difference between ventricular chamber pressure and the extracavitary pressure, which could be pericardial or pleural. So when we breathe quietly at atmospheric pressure or around that, our transmural left ventricular pressure, which is equivalent to the afterload that the left ventricle sees, is about the same as LV pressure. If we breathe in deeply against a closed glottis, so we perform a Müller maneuver, or even take a very deep breath in and make our intrathoracic pressure very negative, that produces, let's say, an intrathoracic pressure or a pleural pressure of minus 20. So the transmural pressure then becomes 140. So that deep breath, that Müller maneuver, increases the transmural left ventricular pressure and therefore the left ventricular afterload. If instead we provide a positive pressure, a positive airway pressure and a positive pleural pressure, with positive pressure ventilation obviously, then the transmural pressure drops. So that's favorable to the left ventricle. And the last schematic there just shows the impact a vasodilator would have on those transmural pressures. So we drop the blood pressure to 100 with a vasodilator. We then perform whatever maneuver gives us the very negative pleural pressure, and we restore the transmural pressure to 120, so around the baseline before the blood pressure was dropped with a drug.